there and all. So then now, but just see, yes, Muthukaruppan, Mr. Kar, I have not admitted any notice. No, there is no, nothing in the
Honorable
Mr. Muthukaruppan.
Mr. Muthukaruppan. Chairman, sir. Thank you very much to speak.
Nothing
on
will go on record.
Budget.
Please don't do anything in the last day like this.
I express my sincere thanks and gratitude to our leader, Purachandra.
Nothing shall go on record.
For
please.
The guiding
please,
spirit for
all please
of
sit
us
down.
In Tamil Nadu.
No, no.
Our honorable
nothing shall go on record.
Nothing.
I will not entertain anything.
Welcome the budget 2020-21 and lauded that the budget as a progressive budget for the growth of the nation. This budget is aimed to benefit all
Muthukaruppanji should go on record
without imposing
both electronic and print. Muthukaruppanji has to be
without
taken note. Other things will not
will
go on record.
The expectations of people besides sowing seeds for the growth in the future. So the budget proposals give impetus to
bring the order in the house.
It is aimed at making the future of the people of prosperous.
I am not allowing. I am not allowing your point of order because there is no order.
The central themes of this budget. And hence our Honorable Chief Minister and Edappadi K. Palanisamy has welcomed and thanks the Finance Minister for allotting a total of 2.83 lakh crore rupees for the year 2022-21. Out of that, 1.60 lakh crore for agriculture, irrigation and allied activities and rupees 1.23 lakh crore for the rural development and Panchayat Raj institutions. Again, sir. Tamil Nadu has been the cradle of civilization and is one of the oldest and most advanced civilization in the annals of world history. I express our sincere thanks and gratitude to the Honorable Finance Minister for announcing Adichinallur as part of the upgrading 5 archaeological sites in the country. Our Chief Minister has requested the central government to add Keeladi archaeological site also. I would request the Union government to sanction rupees 50 crore to conduct large-scale archaeological excavations in the ancient sites of Pugugar, Keeladi, Kodimanal, Kodkai in Tamil Nadu to bring out the archaeological and historic greatness of our ancient Tamil civilization. Again, sir, the Adichinallur is one of the important ancient archaeological sites in Tamil Nadu, which is my native place, only 12 kilometers from my birthplace. Was excavated in the year of 1876 by an ethnologist from Germany named Dr. Jacker. The excavation had brought to light back the earthworks, utensils, number of iron weapons and implements, many knives and short sword blades, hatchets, and a huge number of bones and skulls. All these artifacts were taken away by Dr. Jacker for the Berlin Museum, currently called the Ethnological Museum of Berlin. I urge the government to take appropriate measures to bring back those
please
important archaeological
seats. This is not
evidences
the way
to India. Again, sir.
This is not the way.
Again, sir. Sir, I am coming to the sensitive issue of hydrocarbon issue, the state of Tamil Nadu, sir. Sir, I am telling that my Chief Minister, Honorable Edappadi K. Palanisamy, has written a letter to Honorable Prime Minister on 21-1-2020, Government of Tamil Nadu strongly opposed the hydrocarbon extraction projects in the Delta region of Tamil Nadu, which is an ecologically fragile agricultural zone, sir. Again, sir, the Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu and Edappadi K. Palanisamy wish to state that the following additional facts, based on various empirical reports, which will clearly reinforce the need to preserve the ecologically sensitive agricultural zone of Delta region of Tamil Nadu, comprising of Tanjavur, Thiruvarur, Nagapattinam districts and Delta Plains of Pudukottai, Kadalur, Tiruchi, Karur and Ariyalur district, which contributes to over 32% of state's food production in an area of 22 lakh areas. Again, sir, the Delta region of Tamil Nadu is known for its rich archaeological and cultural heritage since centuries. The famous archaeological monuments like Pragadeeswaran Temple of Tanjavur, the Kangaikonda Cholapuram Temple, the Namakraha Temples, the Velakandi Church and the Nagur Tarka lie in this region, and it is apprehended that hydrocarbon exploration and the consulting mining of hydrocarbons will destroy the cultural heritage of our country. My Honorable Chief Minister would like to bring to your kind notice that I have already announced that the state government will take necessary legal action to declare the Kaveri Delta region as an ecologically sensitive agricultural zone and request the government of India to support this. Yesterday, we met all my ADMK party MPs, including my floor leader, Mr. Ravindra Dixon, met Honorable Forest and Environmental Minister, and as well as the Petroleum Minister. We discussed the hydrocarbon problem. The minister promised us not to interfere the matter of Tamil Nadu against the building of state of Tamil Nadu. Promise. I am thanking to honorable ministers, honorable Javadekar, honorable Dharmendra Pradhan, and also the Parliament Affairs Minister, Prakash Jogi. And also, we are very thankful to honorable Prime Minister of India not to interfere in the interest of the Tamil Nadu against the mind of the Tamil Nadu. So we are opposing hydrocarbon scheme. So it is accepted by the government of India. We are very, very thankful to the ministers and prime minister of our country. They are saying that they promised us not to interfere against the willingness of the state of Tamil Nadu. Thank you so much, sir. Again, sir, I have also urged the center to consider Tamil Nadu government's demand to do the development works and tourist destination, as the Union government has announced a scheme with an outlay of 4,500 crore to offer subsidy to states to improve the tourism sector. While we welcome the proposed National Recruitment Agency, we demand that it should conduct comprehensive exams in Tamil also. I am happy that the budget has gone around three prominent themes, aspirational India, in which all sections of the society seek better standards of living with access to health, education, and better jobs. It is heartening to see that the Indian government has decided to create warlords in line with warlords developed under regulatory authority norms, and also to build a seamless national coal supply chain, and also for perishables, inclusive of milk, meat, fish.
Please.
The Indian Railways will set up a Kisan Rail through PPP arrangements. The Kisan Udan scheme to be lauded by the Ministry of Civil Aviation and International and National Roads is an innovative beekeeping, solar pumps, solar energy products in non-cropping season should be added. The inclusion of zero budget natural farming and opening the
rest
online
of the session, you will not be allowed to speak. Please sit down. Very senior member, you know the rules. You have been both in government and opposition.
Again,
for
sir,
the rest of the session, please.
I welcome the section of rupees 99,300 crore for education sector in 2022-21, and about rupees 3,000 crore for skill development. Sir, the skill development is very important for getting the first job ready. Education without skill is useless, and it is unfortunate that the normal education in our country do not impart or sharpen the skills of the person, sir. Again, sir, further, one more thing, sir, I would like to say. The proposed Delhi-Mumbai Expressway and the Chennai-Bangalore Expressway are very much important and will play a great role in our economic growth, sir. The setting up of a large solar power capacity alongside the rail tracks and the land owned by the railways is highly innovative and will augment our green energy generation, sir. Again, sir, the need of Tamil Nadu, sir, rupees 7,000 crores is still pending. Are reimbursed to Tamil Nadu for implementing the centrally sponsored welfare schemes. The pending dues include rupees 2,109 crores under the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan scheme, reimbursement of 1,092 crore under the Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan scheme, rupees 1,834 crore GST compensation, etc., and rupees 1,196 crore under the Finance Commission grants for local bodies. Therefore, I urge the Union government to expedite the payment of arrears about the government of Tamil Nadu, sir. Sir, I am once again thankful to the Central Government of India, Honorable Prime Minister of India, and Honorable Forest and Environment Minister, Honorable Javadekar, and Brother and Dharmendra Pradhan, sir, because they are saying that they promised us they are not interfere in the Delta area. against that hydrocarbon scheme, sir. They promised us. We are thankful, sir. I wish to thank our Honorable Prime Minister and Honorable Finance Minister for
thank you, Mr.
Muthukaruppan, platform for us to come together to create the new India. Let us together make a new India and make India the world superpower. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Nandri. Thank you. For the sake of the information of the other members, Mr. Navneet Krishnan, please sit down. This issue was raised in the House. I permitted it earlier. You can't go on dictating to me and then shout and then say, sir, you have to allow it. I am the last person to do it. And I have allowed the discussion. Discussion was held on both the issues. And now again you want to discuss because one party went to minister, other party, both you also can go to the minister, discuss with the minister, both of you happily. But don't obstruct the House. I will not allow. I will not allow. Once I say means, I will not allow. There is a